YouTubers, I'm glad you're here. Thank you for joining me. Yesterday at 6:01 p.m., there was an earthquake along the Bartlett Springs Fault Zone, a magnitude 3.8 that 52 people took the time to report that they felt. The Bartlett Springs Fault Zone, I got drawn out in red here. You can see we got a step here for the block zone, is the slow moving creep zone. Different sections of the fault have built up pressure because it's locked. Back in 2016, there was a magnitude 5.1 earthquake. That was the largest earthquake in that area in probably decades. This fault zone is capable of having a magnitude 7.2 earthquake. The fault is trying to move about a half an inch a year going towards the north. You can see this image here of the fault zone and the location of that 5.1 in 2016. The fault runs about 100 miles through Lake County from Round Valley Indian Reservation in the north through the waters of Lake Pillsbury until it ends in the south when it crosses Bartlett Springs Road east of Clear Lake, California. Here we have another image of Bartlett Springs Fault and Clear Lake and that 5.1 earthquake. Let's zoom in here to Scott Dam. Yeah, so the danger for a large earthquake and a rupture for this dam is quite significant. The dam is owned by PG&E. They don't seem too much concerned about a large earthquake and a dam failure. Recently there's been discussion about removing the dam. I did find a paper from June of this year. It is a man-made lake. In fact, my house that I owned in Lake County, Lakeport, California, was actually a garage that came from that area that was moved when the lake was formed. So if they did remove the dam because of its danger, it would affect the water for a lot of people there in Lake County, the flow of rivers, tourism, things like that. But there is a great threat of a failure from a large earthquake, and it probably would fail if there was a 7.2 earthquake. Geologists consider that the Bartlett Springs Fault is probably the easternmost branch of the St. Andreas Fault Zone. They don't have a lot of earthquakes along here because, it's locked. So it's not allowing the movement of the fault until there's an earthquake in different locations. I did find a post on Twitter from USGS showing the movement of the fault. They really don't have it broken down. What areas have moved and what areas are locked, things like that. Here's an image of the house that I used to own. Looks like they built a garage. This is the first home that I ever owned. The biggest problem was the water would come down the road and right into my kitchen, which is this part of the building right here. Looks like they added on a garage and, to the side of the house. But originally the garage door when I bought the house was still in the wall and the wall was tilted. And, when I took out, the walls and put up, new sheetrock and things like that, I found that the door was not closed all the way. And then we put in some new windows and things like that for it. I originally painted it what I called Volkswagen yellow. It was a bright yellow, and I had daffodils and things like that planted out front. Doesn't look like it's changed all that much since I owned it. Looks like in the last week there's been 6 earthquakes in this location, the largest being a 3.8, and then we got it's up over here, a 1.9, a 1.8, There's the 3.8, a 2.5, a 1.8, and then a 2.0, all fairly shallow. The deepest, I would say, was probably this 1.8. That was 6 miles in depth. But the 3.8 was only 3.5 miles in depth. I can't remember ever feeling any earthquakes when I lived there in Lake County. When they started having earthquakes, probably 1990, I want to say, when they started pumping the water back into the ground for the geothermal energy because the wells were going dry up there on Cobb Mountain. That's when the earthquakes started. And they have continued. Yeah, you can see right here all the earthquakes up there. This area lies between the Makama Fault. And then up over here on the right is the Bartlett Springs Fault. And then over here would be the geysers. Yeah, for the geothermal. Yeah. A lot of these buildings in this area are brick and mortar. So a large earthquake would be devastating. A lot of people would die. So, yeah, like I said, it's locked. It's supposed to be creeping. But it doesn't creep unless there's an earthquake that relieves the stress from being locked. Yeah, it's supposed to be moving about a half an inch a year. So what are your thoughts? Put your thoughts down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.